Hello, sophomores, Mr. Marks. I promised myself I'd make you guys a little bit of a cheat sheet for your personal narrative essays. I wasn't really happy with kind of the first time around and our outline for our personal narratives, or it's kind of difficult to interpret. So I just thought I'd show you kind of a formulaic way to approach the essay. So, you know, you've seen this before. If we look at the paragraph one, our opening introductory paragraph of this formulaic five paragraph essay, it kind of emulates an upside down triangle as we start from a very broad statement, right? We call that the hook. And then we have sentences two, three, and four, which gradually become more specific and get us to our thesis statement, the most specific sentence. So really, paragraph one is a five sentence paragraph. Starts with a hook, which is a catchy statement. We want to avoid being cliche. This is a no-go. What do I mean by cliche? Here's an example of a cliche sentence. Everyone wants to be happy. It's cliche from the words of my eighth block because everyone knows this already, right? So try to say something that's catchy that maybe hasn't been said quite like that and helps intro your paper, okay? And so then when we give sentence two, three, and four, we gradually become more specific and ultimately end on our thesis statement. The formula, which I don't like, but learn the rules so we can forget them later, for thesis statement is subject plus your argument or opinion, claim. It's all the same thing. You know, sharks don't exist. You could argue with me, make a claim, plus your three supporting details, okay? Three supporting details. You should have already determined which details from the graphic organizer you're going to use for body paragraph. So here's it all together, okay? My cultural identity, that's the subject. Make a claim, you know, this is your argument, is defined by, I might argue with you, so this is why it's an argument. I could. My cultural identity is defined by my family dynamic, our religious practice, and the neighborhood I was raised in. Three things. And if you notice over here, my family dynamic is going to be the subject of paragraph two, right? Our religious practice is going to be the subject of paragraph three. The neighborhood is going to be the subject of paragraph four. Remember that list of 14 items or so from the graphic organizer? You're going to pick three. So here is an example of a potential paragraph one, introductory paragraph, right? Humanity is dynamic. I don't think that's cliche. It's a statement. It's broad. It's simple. And we're going to gradually get more and more specific as we approach our thesis statement. Okay, humanity is dynamic. We are the sum of our experiences, where we grew up, and who influenced our early choices. These variables shape who we are and assure that no two people are the same. I don't know anyone else quite like me. Thesis statement. My cultural identity is defined by my family dynamic, our contrasting religious beliefs, and the neighborhood I grew up in. See, over here, we're getting to our thesis, we're getting closer to our thesis, we are the closest to our thesis, right? It's becoming more specific, and then this is the mothership of our paper. This is what it's all about. And these three things, family dynamic, contrasting religious beliefs, neighborhood I grew up in, these are going to be my paragraphs. Paragraph two, paragraph three. Okay, so there you go. Body paragraphs, you need to have a topic sentence, which is like a hook. It's like a hook. And it intros the subject of that paragraph. So remember my first paragraph, body paragraph, is going to be about family dynamic. So I have to have a topic sentence about family dynamic. And then I have to have a conclusion sentence. And then you have to have sentences in between. Now, all of these sentences in between, for our purposes of this assignment, formulaic, have to be at least 8 sentences. So how are we going to do that? I would suggest that you can do this, which is topic sentence, concrete detail, which is going to be your story. Then you're going to comment on that story. Then you're going to comment on that story again. Then you're going to give me another concrete detail. Then you're going to comment on that story. You're going to comment on that story. And then you're going to give me a conclusion type sentence for that particular body paragraph. Right? A lot of us, though, are potentially good writers, right? We are sophisticated writers. So we are going to definitely give a topic sentence. And then we might give another topic sentence, right? And then we might, you know, give some concrete detail that's, you know, I don't know, 3 sentences long with a little bit of commentary, maybe like 3 sentences long as well, and just keep on going and just have something just rolling with it. And I'll give you an example of that. Essentially, you don't necessarily need to adhere to this formula over here, but for those of us who are struggling and developing, nothing wrong with that. We might. So let's take a look at my opening paragraph. It seems kind of negative, and I'm just using it as an example. Contradictions abound in my family. While my father spent time in a credential program and ultimately became a teacher, understanding learning styles fell by the wayside. I had fallen in the pool on accident. I remember instantly not caring that my 6-shooter cap gun, my most prized possession of my 4-year-old self, had become filled with water along with my boots. I remember looking up at him, his recognizable form blurred by the water and light refracting up. He still didn't lend a hand when I eventually flailed my way to the surface. "Pop, please, please help," I pleaded. He didn't, but I learned to swim. Because of these types of events, I promised myself that I would care for others demonstratively or something like that. So if we really analyze this bit of writing, these two sentences right here, these guys, there's 2 sentences that are kind of like topic sentences that introduce it, and that's okay, right? And then where's my concrete detail, my story? Well, it starts here. I had fallen in the pool, and then it keeps going and going and going. And really, when I analyze it, I analyze here. All of these sentences are my story, my concrete detail for my own life. And then I only really give 1 sentence of commentary. I probably need to have more. So let's add a couple to it. So I don't know, you can count the sentences yourself, but essentially this is sophisticated writing, if I do say so myself, and you're welcome to give that a go. Or options, stick to this. Granted, if family is the topic of my body paragraph 1, then I probably should talk about a little bit. Anyway, I hope this clears things up. I will discuss this in class with you later. Thanks.